May nagtanong, di ba? Ano yung tanong?
Kung ano daw yung difference ng dividend investing at high growth investing ba yun? Or stock investing? Bali. So, naka-forma kami dahil nakagaling lang na talk.
Yes, welcome to another episode of Well, Arky.
Yes.
And dahil interactive tayo, okay, nagaya po ko.
Ayoko, sige.
Dahil interactive tayo, may nagtanong, di ba? Ano yung tanong?
Kung ano daw yung difference ng dividend investing at high growth investing ba yun? Or stock investing? Bali.
Take two. Okay, may tanong.
Ano yung difference ng dividend investing and capital growth investing?
Dividend investing and capital growth investing. Yeah. And parang ano, no? I think isa sa mga nag-comment natin is which one should he or she go for?
I think the question arise because either naghanap siya ng stocks na dividend or usually kasi yung mga co-ops nagbibigay din ng dividends.
Okay.
So parang na-curious siya kung saan ba siya pupunta.
Oh.
And parang similar din sa lines ng MP2.
Ah, yan. Pag-ibig MP2. Na, meron din po tayong video. Yan. Okay, if you just check our playlist. Okay. So what's the deal? Okay, first and foremost, dividend muna.
Sige, ano?
Diba? Yung mga dividend paying stocks usually ito yung mga PLDT, GMA, you know. Well, basically any company naman could declare dividends, okay, as long as if it's on in line with their business practice at syempre kung company ka, no, kung minsan if you're on growth expansion, okay, sometimes hindi nabibigyan dividend yung company kasi imbis na magbigay ng pera back to the shareholders, they retain yung kinikita nila for further expansion.
Ayan. For our viewers na hindi alam ko ano yung dividends, ano ba talaga siya?
Dividends yun lang yung binabalik na pera na mga kunwari, shareholder ka sa ano ba, PLDT, ayan, usual, nabibigyan dividend yan. Okay, so for example, nagsabi sila na, Metrobank pala, nagbigay ng dividends.
Recently,
parang
diba?
30 cents per share. So for example, meron kang 1,000 shares ng Metrobank, halimbawa, times 30 cents, okay, then, yun yung matatanggap mo amount of dividends. Yan.
At least, so, diba?
May meron ka pa rin.
Uh-oh.
Okay, so, should you go for dividend investing? Yun ang tanong. O, ano take mo?
Depende pa rin sa goal.
bakit? Sige ka.
Because, not only the goal, and depending kung ilang percentage of dividends yung nagbibigay.
Okay.
Because if, let's say, yung dividend share 4%, 3%.
Okay.
Eh, yung goal mo, let's say, medium, long term. Tapos 4% lang siya. Hindi ka, alam mo yun, you cannot reach closer to your goal kung dividends lang yung rinirely mo.
Okay. Kung sa dividend ka lang mabuhay.
Oo.
Okay. Okay, fair enough.
But, if let's say, mga 5 years, short term yung goals, baka pwede pa yung dividends for you. Though, okay. I would understand na may mga dividends na nagbibigay, let's say, 10%, 5%, 7%. Baka yun yung...
Lalo na yung mga co-ops, di ba? Some cooperatives give as much as 12% in terms of dividends sa mga kasama natin sa co-op.
I actually know of some clients na minsan 12 to 14.
Oh, not bad, ha?
Pero mga credit co-ops naman.
Ah, yeah. So, depende rin sa ma'am. So, whether cooperatives or corporations, okay, syempre, it really also depends on your goal. But, kung titingnan natin sa mga companies right now na usually nagbibigay ng dividends, okay, like PLDT, ganyan, which is very much in the know na nagbibigay ng dividends. Kung makikita natin, these are usual companies na ano na, na mature companies already and are in the sector na mature na like telcos. Why? Bakit sila nagbibigay ng dividend? Kasi syempre, mature na yung sector eh.
Yeah,
so they don't have
true.
Much room to grow. So yung kinikita nila, syempre hindi ka na maka-expand, then they give back the earnings essentially to their shareholders. So, dividend investing or capital growth, again, tama ka dun, depende sa goal mo, but syempre, kung ako lang, no, kung bata ka pa, then you should be more into capital growth. Kasi syempre, gusto mo yung pera mo, lumalago pa. Diba? Kasi kung mapapansin na yung mga dividend paying stocks, yung in terms of their price appreciation, hindi na sila masyadong lumalaki.
Yeah, usually may listahan ng dividend stocks and what I noticed is mostly flat yung
mostly flat.
Price rate nila.
Kasi again, hindi na sila lumalaki. So they give you the money back. So yeah. If you're still young and you know you want to save up for your retirement, for your child's education or any other long-term goal, ako I would bet on dapat wag ka sa dividend. Doon ka sa stock na yung price per share is lumalaki. Para nag-appreciate yung share share price mo. Yeah. So when do you go for dividend?
May naisip ako just now. Feeling ko kapag
prepared ka.
Retired ka na.
Yeah, mag-retire.
Because you need the passive income if in case hindi mo na build up yung retirement corpus mo.
Ano yung retirement corpus?
Yung retirement fund mo.
Retirement. Tama.
So, diba at least meron kang pera para sa mga gasto mo. Tapos baka kasi, minsan kasi most of our retirees may utang pa or may apo na, alam mo yun, nagbibigay ng aginaldo.
So on top of your pension, okay, on top of your pension and top of yung mga bond investment natin, a dividend paying stock is good for a retirees, retirees portfolio as well. So, syempre, yun nga, tulad na nasabi mo, yung mga regular na gastos, di ba? At least, you have the cash flow going in. Kasi, again, kapag retiree ka, tapos umaasa ka lang sa price appreciation o movement ng stock market para lang kumita, then, kung down ang market, hindi mo marirealize it. So, yes, dividend investing is good for retirees as well.
Especially now, no? Na-down yung market dahil sa mga
sa mga trade war and then the COVID-19
tapos
etcetera.
Na Taal volcano pa
So yes, dividend is really position for for those who are into yun, naghahanap ng cash flow.
Yes, and another good dividend probably which we already discussed was your preferred shares.
Preferred shares, yes. That's
preferred
right.
Preferred or preferred?
What the fuck? I don't know. Oh, that's right. Preferred shares. So, ibigay din na ng regular income.
Yeah. Pero yung caveat dyan for preferred shares is that hindi siya dinideclare every now and then ng company. But wait for announcements via your trading brokers or websites
or
because
Facebook. May press up kayo, ganyan.
Because usually, ina-announce doon kung may preferred shares yung company. Recently, yung nag-declare last year was Ali and another company na medyo second tier stock. Nag-declare siya ng preferred shares last year.
Though, so, okay. Oh, yeah.
One more thing kasi with preferred shares, may limited ano lang siya. Offer period.
Ah, limited lang. Special offer.
Yeah, special. Parang special offer siya, which I think medyo na-miss out sa video na.
Okay.
But if you want to learn more about preferred shares versus common shares, you can check our playlist.
Yes. So that's it. So you can get your dividends, either cooperative, ano ba ba? Preferred shares or the ordinary stock. And really, it depends on your financial goal, yung cash requirement nyo, if you would go for dividend paying or capital price appreciation.
Yeah.
So, but I think,
MP2 din sa dividends.
Ah, yeah, MP2 as well. Mabibigay din ang dividend. At dami kasi
dividends. I think dahil yun yung reason ko bakit nagtatanong sila.
So, again, so thank you. So, that's it for
that's
now.
It.
For our episode. So, if you like our video, please
give us a thumbs up.
And then share our video. And of course, hit on the subscribe button to subscribe on
and
our video.
And that notification bell.
Notification. Tabawas if it's too
early.
Thank you. See you next week.
Bye-bye.